Professor Henny is a professor at School of Pharmacy, Institute Teknologi Bandung, and the head of Research Center for Nanoscience and Nanotechnology, Institute Teknologi Bandung. Professor Henny research area and expertise is antidrug therapy, anti-aging material, targeted drug delivery, drug formulator, and nanomedicine. So without further ado, I would like to invite Prof. Henny to give her lecture for today. So Prof. Henny, the time is yours.
Okay, thank you very much for a short introduction about me. Good morning, everybody. How are you? So welcome to International Virtual Course conducted by Research Center for Nanosciences and Nanotechnology, Badung Institute of Technology, Indonesia. So first of all, yeah, as a head of this center, I would like to thank, yeah, to appreciate all participants who register and who contribute to this international virtual course. And this year, yeah, we do the course virtually because of bad situation globally. And of course, I hope everybody today is in good health condition. Okay, as moderator mentioned, my topic, can I share? Can you hear my voice clearly?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, thank you. So allow me to share. Belum bisa ya? Okay, wait. So sorry, I just share desktop. Now I go to summer course. Okay, is my presentation can be seen?
Yes.
Okay, so more or less 30 minutes, I would like to deliver my topics today. So the topic title is Natural-Based Quantum Dot for Theranostic Application. So I hope all participants have a short background regarding to the quantum dots and what the material of quantum dots behind. Yeah. So in this lecture, I focus using natural material to synthesize or to produce quantum dots. And then I will show you what is the application of quantum dots, not only in medicinal application, but also actually other field. Yeah, but because my specialization is in pharmacy medicine, so I focus more the application of quantum dots in medicine. So in the theranostic area. So before I go in deeply, so I would like just to introduce what is carbon dots. Yeah, so quantum dots, carbon dots is one of them. So carbon dot is a new type of carbon based zero dimensional material. Yeah, so from the word we can imagine that this particle is derived from carbon, C, in chemical notation is C, carbon, So what is the benefit of this carbon dots? So first is excellent photostability, then favorable biocompatibility, low toxicity, Yeah, carbon is human also one of element is carbon. Yeah, so that's why biocompatibility is high. Then low toxicity, outstanding water solubility, high sensitivity, and excellent selectivity for target analytes. Turnable fluorescence emission and excitation, high quantum yield, and also large Stokes sieve. Yeah. So because of this benefit, that's why many application can be derived from the carbon dots. Okay, as I mentioned before, I focus on the natural material. So one of the materials is biomass. Yeah. So biomass is a good carbon source for the preparation of biomass carbon dot. Yeah. We call biomass carbon dot. Carbon dots is produced by biomass. Yeah. So why biomass is important, yeah, for the carbon dots? Yeah, because the biomass carbon sources are eco-friendly natural product compared to other carbon sources and have many advantages. Yeah, for example, here inexpensive. Yeah, biomass is like waste, so we can get anywhere. Yeah, and no cost. Yeah, very cheap. Easy to obtain, yeah, abundant, and green because from nature. And then the most important is can convert low value biomass waste, yeah, into valuable and useful material, yeah. So we know that biomass waste is nothing, yeah, but behind this we can convert, yeah, the unvaluable material into valuable and very useful material. Yep. So the biomass containing heteroatoms, yeah, is the best raw material for the preparation of carbon dots. In contrast to the carbon dot of man-made carbon sources, yeah, that require the addition of external heteroatom. Yeah, so because of this, biomass getting attractive, yeah, in the field of quantum dot. So here you can see the picture, yeah, telling about the milestone, yeah, of the natural based quantum dot. So starting from year 2010, yeah, you see the carbon, yeah, and the sand, yeah, and then by year, yeah, you see annually, yeah, until 2018. So the sources of quantum dots getting more and more variable, yeah. So from the sand, coffee, fruit, yeah, and the waste here, yeah, a watermelon waste, a watermelon skin, and vegetable. So I believe that all of you familiar with this picture, yeah, with this fruit, with this vegetable. Yeah, even we can use also crab, yeah, we can use fear, yeah, fear from bird, from chicken, yeah, from the poultry, and also from fish, yeah. So all these natural sources, yeah, is potential, yeah, to produce a quantum dot, yeah. Especially carbon dots, yeah, and this of course because from nature, so green and sustainable, yeah, sustainable is really important, yeah, because with the sustainability of these sources we can keep the material, yeah, the carbon dot for different application, yeah, for many application, not only for medicine but also we can see later, yeah. So here you can see the bio application, yeah, of natural based quantum dot. Okay, here, yeah, solar cell. Yeah, solar cell is out of my field, yeah, but participant who really interested, yeah, in solar cell, so you can think about the natural based quantum dot for solar cell. Also for catalysis. yeah, and many others. So now maybe we will ask how we can chain from the biomass into carbon dot. Okay, here I will show you different methods to synthesize biomass carbon dots. First, before that, so this is short information that the biomass carbon dot synthesis strategies are based on two main methods actually, top down and bottom up. So top down, for example, based on cutting the larger carbon material or fusing smaller precursor. So the bottom up is from the large material into the small material. And in the other way around, bottom up method is from the smaller precursor molecule into a bigger, bigger particle, bigger material. Okay, so the top down method, you can see here the various method. For example, oxidizing cutting, cutting based the oxidation reaction, and then reducing cutting, So this is just opposite, opposite chemical reaction. One is oxidation, the other one is reduction, and then can be also physical, physical grinding. Or can be combination of chemical and physical method, to obtain more optimal product, So the preparation of biomass carbon dot, with the bottom up approach, For example, here fusion of organic molecules under the thermal or hydrothermal or solvent thermal condition. Or the carbonation of the organic precursor, precursor. So people can choose, which one is the best or the most suitable method for their aim, depend on the aim and the characteristic of the biomass carbon dot they expect, So both is okay, both are okay, but which one depend on the formulator, of course. So first I will start with this one, hydrothermal carbonization method. So this one of the bottom method, to synthesize biomass carbon dot. So we just sort this term into HTC, HTC, is the hydrothermal carbonization method, So the thermochemical degradation of biomass, So degradation induced by thermochemical, from the biomass in the presence of water, must be in wet condition, and we can use a various ratio between water and the biomass, so ranging from 5:1 to 75:1, at elevated temperature and pressure, depend on the biomass, So as previous slide mentioned, that can be from animal, can be from a plant, So the temperature will be adjusted, And HTC is a promising technique, for converting biomass into novel carbon material for a wide variety of potential application. One of them is medicine. So the second thing I would like to show you, a vegetable derived biomass carbon dot. So why we use vegetable? Okay, as we see that vegetable are rich in bioactive compound, like vitamins, minerals, and other beneficial ingredients. So that's why we consume vegetable every day, to support our health. So the vegetable also used as carbon source, and the biomass carbon dots prepared by hydrothermal method were evenly distributed, with the size ranging from 2 to 8 nanometer. So you can imagine very tiny particle, yeah, from 2 to 8 nanometer. And biomass carbon dot derived from vegetable using hydrothermal method yield less than 10%. Yeah, meaning we can only get 10% of biomass carbon dot from the raw material. Yeah. So the vegetable already used for this, for example here, yeah, mushroom, lentils, coriander leaf, sweet potato, and also carrot juice. Yeah, so I think you can find this every day. Yeah? You can find this vegetable every day. Okay, because of low yield, yeah. So in order to improve, yeah, the yield, so biomass carbon dot was prepared with the same method, but not using the previous vegetable I just saw, but they use onion waste. Okay, so onion waste as a carbon source. Yeah, so the onion waste, why we use onion waste? Because rich in dietary fiber, yeah, and also rich in alkanil cysteine sulfoxide, and also non-structural carbohydrate. So with this waste, yeah, the yield can be up to 28%. Yeah, the difference is in the size. Yeah, you see bigger, yeah, 7 and 25 nanometer. Yeah, so that's why, as I mentioned before, which one source is good for BCD is depend on the our expectation. Yeah, the yield, the particle size, or other. And if we use a sweet pepper, yeah, as a carbon source, so we will have high quality biomass carbon dots, yeah, with up conversion fluorescent, were prepared by also with the hydrothermal treatment, yeah, and the temperature used for this preparation is 180 degrees Celsius in autoclave, yeah. Okay, so I hope the beginning information can bring you, yeah, for the imagination about the biomass carbon dot, the preparation, the characteristic, and also the application. Yeah. So here, more clear, yeah, picture telling about the preparation of biomass carbon dot by hydrothermal method. Yeah. So you see winter melon, yeah, here. So in the process you can see, yeah, from the winter melon with the hydrothermal method, and you use 180 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. From here, yeah, will change to the particle. Yeah, of course here UV radiation, yeah, with the different wavelength, yeah, 360 nanometer. Also the this is the size of the particle, yeah. In the beginning, bigger particle we get, yeah, 360 nanometer or even 448 nanometer, yeah. Then yeah, so this in dissolution, yeah, so then at the end we get this one. And the second one, bee pollens, yeah, this one, yeah, bee pollen. And then sweet pepper, yeah, here you see, and other, yeah, pomelo peel, coriander leaf, yeah. So this is the simple picture, yeah, to illustrate the process. And not only vegetable, yeah, but also fruit, yeah. Fruit can be used as a source, yeah, as a carbon source, yeah. Fruit also contain bioactive component, yeah, like vitamin, yeah, and also a lot of water, sugar, yeah, and other component. Yeah, so the biomass carbon dot prepared by the simple hydrothermal method with different fruit as carbon sources, so will produce different properties. Yeah, but this is the lack of using fruit as carbon source. Yeah, for biomass carbon dot, the size of this biomass carbon dots generally from 2 to 7. Yeah, and the yield is below 10%. Yeah, so as compared to vegetable, maybe vegetable is better than the fruit. Yeah. Sorry, the table is too small to see, but I hope you still have good vision. Yeah, so you see a table showing the biomass carbon dot, yeah, prepared from different carbon sources and their properties, also application. Yeah, so here of course the first method is hydrothermal method. Yeah, as the first method I tell here. So you see the source, yeah, the sources and the size of the carbon dot and the application. Yeah, the application, you can see bioimaging, detecting of ferro, yeah, and then detecting of mercury, yeah, and also a catalyst and many other, yeah. So I cannot read very clearly because very small, but I hope you can see, yeah. And this also similar, yeah. So with same method, different sources, different properties and different application. Okay, and mostly carbon dot is used for bioimaging, yeah, because they have optical properties, yeah, good optical properties. Yeah, we can trace, yeah, and this is very helpful in the medicinal field, yeah. Okay, and this is still a similar issue. And you see at the last list, a different method, yeah, microwave hydrothermal, yeah, meaning using high temperature with the microwave, yeah. Okay, here. So in this table, actually, summary of the method, yeah, for preparing biomass carbon dots. And for detail, for its method like microwave, pyrolysis, chemical oxidation, I will show in the next slide. Okay, this one is microwave method, yeah, the second method after hydrothermal method. So in the microwave method, the irradiation from the microwave is an important supporting method that has been widely applied to the field of chemical synthesis. Yeah, so for example here, yeah, so preparation of biomass carbon dots by pyrolysis, carbonization. Yeah, okay, so this you can see other method, yeah. So pyrolysis maybe in the next one, yeah. But yeah, shortly you can just capture, yeah, the short information and maybe easy to understand. Yeah, the conversion between the raw material into the carbon dots after thermal application, yeah, thermal application like using pyrolysis at 470 degree in the air, so in the, so meaning this is dry process, yeah, and very high temperature, meaning we have to be careful, yeah, and then after that purification and so on, yeah, you can see on the diagram of how to synthesize the carbon dot from different sources and different method. And this one, yeah, chemical oxidation method. Yeah. So chemical oxidation method is a method in which an oxidation, yeah, there is a oxidator, yeah, in the process. Yeah. So this oxidator will oxidize a target by causing the target to lose electron. Yeah, and a method of oxidizing with a strong oxidizing agent. Yeah, so the oxidizing agent, for example, hydrogen peroxide. Yeah, and the use of chemical oxidation method can be convenient and fast, and also large scale production. Yeah, and no need a complex equipment. Yeah, so because of this, yeah, high selectivity. Yeah, so people use this one, yeah, for the large scale production. But there is also lack. Yeah, for example, here, expensive oxidant, yeah, hydrogen peroxide is, yeah, relatively expensive. Yeah, and this is not mild chemical reaction, but little bit irritant, yeah. So hydrogen peroxide is strong oxidator. So using more hydrogen peroxide will cause some pollution, yeah, to the environment. So this is the lack, especially when the large scale production is conducted. And in addition to the pollution, also result intermittent production with a low production capacity. Yeah, so we have to, yeah, smartly thinking, yeah, among the method, which one is the most suitable for our material, yeah. So this is the pyrolysis carbonization method. Yeah, so pyrolysis is the reaction process, yeah, reaction process in which substance is decomposed, yeah, by heat. So this is also using heat, but really high temperature, yeah. For example, 470 degrees. Yeah, so far the pyrolysis method has become one of the common method, yeah, to prepare biomass carbon dot. So with the biomass as the carbon source, particle size prepared by pyrolysis method generally, yeah, very small, yeah, 0.4 and 6 nanometer. And you can see the yield, yeah, from 3% to 25%. Yeah, so different plants use, yeah, for this method. For example, rice, yeah, rice husk, yeah. So not the rice, but rice husk. And then plant leaf, grass, and also genus stema. Okay, so that's the four different method, yeah, for the carbon dot preparation. So now I will show you the properties of the carbon dot, yeah, biomass carbon dot. So as we already know, yeah, that the source of carbon dot is from the natural, yeah. So the main component of this are, so this is the organic element, yeah, nitrogen, carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen, yeah, and this present in various functional group, yeah, like amine, carboxylate, yeah. So it contain these four element, yeah. So the carbon sources for biomass carbon dots production are mainly carbohydrate, yeah. So still remember, yeah, rice husk and then grass, yeah. Also protein, yeah, we still remember fish, crab, and other biomolecule like vitamin, mineral, yeah, and have good water solubility, yeah, because some of the method need water, yeah, to support the preparation. So the biomass carbon dot have uniform, yeah, and dispersed spherical structure and special optical properties of photoluminescence. So that's why the most application is for bioimaging, yeah, biodetecting, something like that, yeah, because of the optical properties, yeah. So in the structural properties, you can see, yeah, actually spherical structure, yeah, and then uniform size. So as you can see here, yeah, you can use a different instrument, yeah, to detect, yeah, to identify the carbon dots, yeah, using scanning electron microscope or transmission electron microscope, or you can use also particle size analyzer, yeah. So different method you can use, like also crystallinity, you can use XRD, yeah, you can use infrared, yeah, also here mass spectrometry, yeah, and other, yeah, many other instrument you can use to identify the properties of the carbon rods. Yeah, especially this one, structural properties, yeah. So here you see the morphology, yeah, and then you confirm, yeah, the morphology with the structure, yeah. Structure, of course, you use specific, yeah, instrument, yeah, like FTIR, yeah, FTIR, and then mass spec, yeah, mass spec, and other specific instrumentation. So for the optical properties, of course, yeah, you can detect the absorbance properties, yeah, the fluorescent, the wavelength, the emission, something like that, yeah. So different instrument can support, yeah, to have the optical properties. Okay, so the two thing, yeah, the two thing properties, but important for the carbon dot is structural and optical, yeah. So now I think the last, well, not the last, yeah, maybe this is close to the last, yeah, application of the biomass carbon dot, yeah. So as my background, yeah, so for drug delivery, yeah, so you can see in the picture, yeah, drug delivery is how to deliver drug into the body, yeah, of the living organism, yeah, can be animal, can be cell, yeah, can be human, and then you can trace, yeah, you can trace the drug localization, yeah, but drug itself actually they don't have what to say properties to respond to external trigger, for example irradiation, thermal, so they don't have, so that's why we need something, yeah, attached to the drug, yeah, or encapsulate the drug, so then the drug can be detect, yeah, where after administration, yeah, in which organ. So the material, yeah, to help drug identification, yeah, in the body is quantum dot, because yeah, optical properties they have, yeah. So depend on the particle size and also the structural properties, so we can see, yeah, we can see, we can make image, yeah, with different color, yeah, because they emit different wavelength, either red, green, blue, etc. So it will be very beautiful, yeah, picture if we know how to optimize, yeah, the properties of carbon. Yeah, so here in the red, yeah, you can detect, yeah, the fate, yeah, after administration until certain time, yeah, and finally gone from the body. Yeah. So first you can see very sharp, and then yeah, fade, yeah, and then finally, gone. Okay, so as mentioned in the topic, yeah, in the title, theranostic, so one of the application for this, yeah, for the carbon dots. So theranostic, coming from therapy and diagnostic, yeah, and the combination between therapy and diagnostic. First, we do diagnostic, yeah, localization of the disease. And then after we know the disease and the status of the disease, then we do therapy. Yeah, so that's why we call theranostic. Yeah, combination of both, yeah, therapy and diagnostic in the one material. Yeah. And we use nanoparticle, yeah. Quantum dot is in the nano range, yeah. As you still remember, the size can be 2 nanometer or 25, yeah, depend on the source of the carbon. So nano size is really important, yeah, in this theranostic, yeah, because yeah, you can see here, yeah, the potential application, yeah, the premise of the nano size. Okay, maybe you can just read later, but because of the time running fast, so I will go fast also, yeah, to finalize my presentation. Yeah, so theranostic, therapy, and diagnostic. So of course, this material contain diagnostic component and the therapeutic component. Yeah, diagnostic component can be radio tracer, yeah, contrast agent, particulate, combination of three of them. Yeah, and the therapeutic component, of course, the drug. Yeah, the drug depend on the disease. So what drug can be used for the the material. Yeah, so can be here, you see, peptide, this molecule, or nanobody molecule targeting human epidermal growth factor receptor and others. Yeah. Okay, so the material for theranostic, yeah, can be various. One of them is quantum dot, but not only quantum dot, we can also use like here, yes, iron oxide, yeah, nanoparticle. So this is iron oxide nanoparticle, and on the surface of this particle, there are many other materials, yeah. So we functionalize, yeah, the nanoparticle with different material like polyethylene glycol, silica, yes, and then other antibody, yeah, to improve the use of this nanoparticle. And then can be also use gold nanoparticle, but again we modify, yeah, the structure, the surface of the gold nanoparticle with different molecule, yeah, depend on the aim of the material, yeah. So can be target to different receptor, we use antibody and other thing. Can be this one, yeah, paginated liposome, similar, we modify the surface with different material, yeah. So different material can be, one of them is the radioactive, yeah, radioactive, because this radioactive will give a signal if we irradiate, yeah. So then we can trace the location of this particle in the body. Okay, so here again, we back to the quantum dot, yeah. So one of other application. So you see here localization of tumor, yeah, with a quantum dot. Yeah, so we want to know in which organ tumor is developed. Yeah. Okay, so back to a previous slide. So here we use theranostic agent based on natural product. Actually, this is the beginning information I just mentioned. Yeah, so it's not far from the beginning presentation. Yeah, so this is just like summarize of what I just presented. So you can recall, yeah, your memory, yeah, to understand better. Yeah, so this again fruit and vegetable, and with a carbonization depend on method and also the size of particle, we can get, yeah, different color, yeah, either red, blue or green. This because different size, yeah, different size, different optical properties, yeah. So this actually just like optical properties respond to the irradiation, yeah, and then reflect the wavelength, yeah, and we can see visually as a color, yeah. So with this different color, that's why we can use, yeah, to localize, yeah, to make a bioimaging, yeah. Then, yeah, we can scan and then we can see, yeah, different color, different particle, and maybe different distribution in the body. So we can detect the presence of this material in the body at the same time, yeah, and we get a complex result, yeah. For example, the tumor metastatic, for example, yeah, already spreading to anywhere, to any part of the body. So with different color, yeah, different size of carbon dot, so we can get different figure, yeah, different color of this tumor. Okay, and in our lab, yeah, we just try using curcumin. Yeah, I think all of you familiar with curcumin. So this one of spice, yeah, spice normally used to color in the food. Yeah, we use this as a carbon source. Yeah, and we get, yeah, the picture of the carbon dot. Yeah, using SEM here, I think. Yeah. And yeah, so this is actually our project, yeah, starting from this year. We try to synthesize the quantum dot using curcumin, and then we will use as a theranostic, yeah, theranostic to detect the presence of virus, for example, coronavirus this, yeah, so right now, yeah, pandemic infected many people in the world, so we can detect the presence of the virus in the body, and then at the same time we can kill the virus, yeah, because quantum dot can function as antivirus, yeah, so this quantum dot of curcumin, that's why function as theranostic, because at the same time in the same material we can do detection and as well as therapy, yeah. So I think this is the last slide of my presentation. So thank you very much for your attention and welcome for the question. Thank you. I give the time back to moderator.
Okay, thank you so much, Professor Henny, for nice and very interesting lecture. So we move to our question and answer session. We have about four questions in the chat box. So maybe I will read the question. First from Mr. Ulis Tiono. So Prof. Henny, if I have a rice husk that carbon happens to be extracted, what method do you propose? Could you describe the critical items on that process?
Okay, so quantum dot from rice husk, yeah, so you ask about the most suitable method. Yeah, actually depend on the aim of the quantum dot, yeah, so for bioimaging or for catalyst or for solar cell, yeah, depend, because different application, so they require different characteristic of the carbon dot. Then if you already know, yeah, if you already know the application and then you know the characteristic demand of the material, then you can determine the method. Yeah, so based on the report, yeah, from other people, so they use different method and the result of carbon dot. So in the size, for example, you need a size in the range 10 nanometer or bigger or smaller, and also the yield. So which yield you need? So of course everybody need a high yield, yeah. So and what the facility you have? So for example, pyrolysis. So pyrolysis need high temperature, yeah, like 500 degrees. So do you have the instrument? Do you have the machine, yeah? Resulting 500 degrees Celsius to do pyrolysis. If you don't have that one, so don't use pyrolysis because you will never achieve the temperature. So go to other method. For example, hydrothermal. Hydrothermal only 180. Or chemical oxidation, you have peroxide, right? Hydrogen peroxide, and combination with thermal, so you will have biomass carbon dot. Yeah, so I suggest first you do analysis, yeah, the aim on the application and the characteristic, and then the facility you have, and after that you will conclude which method you will use for biomass carbon dot preparation. Okay.
Okay. Thank you for the answer. Maybe we move to the next question. What size and shape of BCDs after synthetic bottom up method? What is its uniformity?
Okay. Yeah. So actually, yeah, theoretically, you already follow my presentation. Yeah. So with different method. So the lack and the advantage, yeah, the lack and advantage only talking about yield and size, yeah. So you know, you still remember, yeah. So from four different methods with the yield and the size. Of course, you have to measure, yeah. So the carbon dot to know the size distribution. And then you have to do analysis about the purity, yeah, to get a yield. Yeah, so all method, of course, if you use each method. So you have to do analysis for the product. So the physical analysis, yeah, physical characteristic, for example, the size, crystallinity, yeah, and other, yeah, and the chemical properties like the structure, yeah, oh yeah, and the physical properties also the optical properties, the mechanical properties, morphology, yeah. So first, you have to do many characterization, yeah, with different instrument, yeah. So you have to detect the structural analysis using FTIR or using mass spec, etc. And then you have to measure the size, the purity, yeah, the morphology, yeah, to know whether uniform, yeah, spheric, or maybe irregular form, irregular shape. Yeah, so yeah, not just simply to say that this method will result this character, but the skill of people also needed. Yeah, if you never do a synthesis of biomass carbon dot, maybe at the beginning you don't get any, yeah, you don't get good result. So you have to do optimization, you have to train, and maybe, yeah, to get skill. Yeah, but if you are skillful, so then you will get better, yeah, as you expect. So for example, I expect biomass carbon dot uniform with spherical shape, yeah, and then the range, size range in between 5 to 10 nanometer, for example. Then you can, yeah, modify the procedure. Maybe the temperature is not 180, maybe 150 is enough, yeah. So do optimization is normal, yeah, normal step, yeah, to get the best product as you expect. So that's my answer. I hope you satisfy me with this answer, yeah.
Yes, okay, so we move to the next question. We have from Gardin Muhammad, how to increase the quantum yield besides modify the biomass source? Is it possible to combine several synthesis process and make it more efficient?
Yeah, I think your question is already answered in my slide. Yeah, so yeah, for example, pyrolysis. Yeah, pyrolysis. One benefit of pyrolysis is potential for large scale production. Yeah. And this method also has a disadvantage or lack, yeah. So using high temperature, maybe costly, yeah, because with high temperature, with high energy, if you use electrical machine, so you need electric high power, yeah. So high power meaning high consumption of the energy, so maybe costly. Yeah, but from the source itself, maybe nothing, yeah, because you use waste. But from the method, you have to really smart, yeah, to choose whether this is for research or for marketing, yeah, for commercialization. And if for research, normally for research, you need only small amount, yeah, small quantity. But for commercialization, you need large quantity. Yeah, for research, use no matter whatever method can be applied, because you only synthesize maybe 1 gram or 5 gram of the product. Yeah, so cost is not really issue because still can be affordable. Yeah, but for the large scale, yeah, cost is the most consideration. Yeah, not only yield but also cost. Yeah. For example, I just want to compare. So pyrolysis yield can be 30%, but the cost is 10 times than hydrothermal. Yes, hydrothermal is only 10%. So 10 times 10%, 100, yeah, you get 10 times of the product. Yeah, but in the pyrolysis, you get a high yield, but the cost is really expensive. Yeah, so of course, if I have to choose, I will choose a hydrothermal method because the cost is 10 times lower. Yeah, so with this 10 times lower, I will achieve 30% of yield with cheaper money, yeah, with lower money, something like that. So many consideration you have to check, yeah. So then after then you will conclude, yeah, which one is the best, which one is the most optimum. Okay.
Okay, thank you. So we still have three more questions. Mm. So the next question is, how mechanism BCDs to detect the type of organ damage and deliver the medicine, and what kind of the other method to synthesize BCDs besides hydrothermal and microwave assisted?
So first question is how to detect, how the mechanism, yeah?
Yes, BCDs mechanism to detect the targeted organ.
Yeah, so the most important properties of carbon dots is optical properties, yeah. So they will absorb a certain wavelength of irradiation and they will emit, yeah. So fluorescence, yeah, absorption and emission. So different wavelength will give different color, yeah. So color can be green, blue or red or maybe yellow, yeah. Then when the carbon dot, yeah, as bioimaging, yeah, present in the body, so we can detect using special instrument, yeah. For example, gamma camera, yeah, or we use USG, yeah, ultrasonography or other instrument with will give irradiation, yeah, signal to the si material, yeah, to the carbon dots, and because of certain optical properties, so the signal is kept, and then they will absorb, yeah, the irradiation, the light, yeah, the ray, yeah, with certain wavelength, and then they will emit, yeah. So we scan using scanner, yeah, using scanner connect with the computer, so then we can see on the screen, yeah, so the image, yeah, indicated by the color, yeah, color or maybe not color, maybe dark spot, yeah, yeah, if we use X-ray instrument, yeah, or if we use a gamma camera. Yeah, so the irradiation from the radioactive, yeah, so they will give signal when we scan with the certain wavelength. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so then we can see on the screen whether this is liver or kidney or lung, etc. So of course done by medical people, yeah. So people who really understand about the anatomy of the human anatomy or anatomy, yeah, animal anatomy or human anatomy, so they recognize the location of liver is here, kidney, lung, etc., heart, etc. Yeah, so other part will be black and only the organ containing carbon dot will give a color or light, something like that. So then we can recognize, oh, this is tumor in the liver or tumor in the brain or et cetera, something like that. Yeah, so pathological pathological people, yeah, people who really understand with the anatomy and pathology, they will conduct that activity. Okay, and the second question is about the method.
Yes, maybe for the first question, I think he asked about how the BCDs reach the targeted organ.
So maybe you still remember the picture I show you, that like quantum dot is not just quantum dot, yeah, but on the surface they modify with a different molecule, yeah, to target certain organ. So the organ, certain organ, they will express certain receptor, yeah. So based on this receptor, we can modify, yeah, the material nanoparticle with, for example, antibody. Yeah, for example, we want to detect virus. So what actually present on the surface of virus? So this biomolecule of virus will be a biomarker. Yeah, will be recognized by a particle containing something. Yeah, connect with the receptor on the thing in on the surface of the virus. Yeah, so we have to understand first what the target, and then we have to analyze what target. So because, for example, in liver or in virus, there are many things on the surface. So we only target one thing, yeah, but the most sensitive one, the most selective one. So then based on this sensitive or selective one, so then we derive the particle, yeah, quantum dot. We modify the surface with certain molecule which is connect with this receptor or biomarker. Yeah, so when we inject, yeah, the particle to the body, so they distribute anywhere. Yeah, so when they don't meet, yeah, the receptor will be connect with the surface of particle, they will not attach. So they just flow in the blood circulation. But when the particle meet a virus, for example, yeah, and this is suitable for the, what to say, antibody, for example, yeah, and it will attach directly and specific to that. Yeah, so we direct the particle using specific driver, yeah, specific molecule like antibody or other ligand, yeah, to recognize what present in the body. Yeah, so this is complicated actually, a long story, but just to short, to give short information, is we have to understand. So for example, transportation, yeah, with the special destination. Yeah, so bus, yeah, with specific destination going to New York, for example. So we passenger, yeah, is the quantum dot. Yeah, so we go into the bus going to New York. Yeah, if the bus not reach the New York, yeah, New York City, the bus will not stop. Yeah, when the bus in front of the bus is New York City, the bus will stop. Yeah, so depend on the, what to say, trajectory, yeah, the destination. So we put nanoparticle with this destination. So to liver or to kidney or to lung, etc. So they will find, yeah, the destination. Okay?
Yes. Okay, thank you. For the next, the second question is, what kind of the other methods to synthesis of BCDs besides hydrogenal and microwave assisted?
Yeah, so as I mentioned in my slide, is chemical, yeah, oxidation reduction reaction, yeah, using hydrogen peroxide or pyrolysis method. Yeah, so there are four methods actually in this my slide. So first hydrothermal, and then pyrolysis, microwave, and biochemical chemical method. Yeah, chemical can be reduction, oxidation, using oxidator or reductor, something like that. Yeah, we can use also combination, of course. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. For the next question, it's Professor Henny. Are there specific requirements or properties of for drug substance to be able to attach or conjugate it to quantum dots? Or could any drug substance be conjugated to quantum dots? Thank you.
Okay, maybe I want to share again my slide, yeah. So for example, we use here, yeah, liposome, yeah, liposome from lipid, yeah. So we have a particle with the size in the range of less than 50 nanometer, yeah. So the drug, for example, the drug is anti-cancer, yeah. Anti-cancer normally lipophilic. So in liposome, there are two parts, lipophilic and hydrophilic. So because the drug is lipophilic, so the drug will be encapsulated in the lipophilic compartment. So in here. So for example, this yellow, yeah, yellow with the red outer, yeah. So the drug will be here. So this encapsulation is just happen physically, not a chemical reaction. Yeah. And then, yeah. So as I mentioned before, to target specific organ. So if the liposome is a naked liposome, meaning on the surface is no biomolecule or no this accessory, so they will not go to specific organ. Yeah, to go to specific organ, we have to put certain molecule. For example, here antibody. Yeah, antibody for targeting. Yeah, so this antibody depend organ. Yeah, what organ to target? So of course, to target liver is different with to target kidney or to target brain or to target breast, etc. Yeah, so this antibody can be replaced. Yeah, with other. Depend on the target, okay? Yeah, so attachment of antibody on the surface of a liposome is happen chemically. So the antibody is chemical, yeah? So it has a functional group. So we have to know the functional group of the lipid which can react with the functional group of the antibody, yeah? So antibody is not drug, but this is as a driver. Yeah. So the drug is here. So the drug is located in this inside, and just entrapped. Yeah, not a chemical reaction. But other particle, for example, dendrimer. So the drug must be chemically interact with the dendrimer. So dendrimer is also carrier, yeah, vesicle to bring the drug. Yeah, so that's why depend on the carrier, yeah, whether the drug will be encapsulated physically or will attach to the carrier. Yeah, if the attachment is happen chemically, so we have to know which reaction, which functional group of the drug will be reacted with the functional group of the carrier. Yeah, so with this explanation, I hope will help. But of course, if you are not familiar with drug targeting or other, maybe more difficult to understand. But I hope you have the basic understanding of my explanation, something like that. So depend what carrier we use, whether physically or chemically. When the physically happen, you don't care about the chemical structure, but if the attachment happen chemically, you have to consider about the chemical structure. Yeah, so the suitable between the quantum dot, yeah, and the drug. Yeah, because quantum dot has structural properties, right? As I mentioned before. Yeah, so to get interaction, whether chemically or physically, yeah. So that's it. Okay. So is it clear?
Maybe I think yes. So actually we still have one more question. Is it okay? Because the time actually up.
Mm-hmm.
Is it okay? Okay. So the last question is, in preparation using thermal process or microwave as mentioned, it's not gonna change the characters of active natural compounds. And to apply for drug delivery, how to calculate suitable dosage to apply and how to control the certain dosage of active compounds will successfully deliver to targeted tissue or cell?
So the first, I missed the first because the voice is up and down.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Okay. In preparation using thermal process or microwave as mentioned, is it not going to change the characters of active natural compounds?
Okay. So actually the application of heat, high temperature, is just to change the biochemical in the source to carbon. Yeah, because we produce carbon dot. So the final chemical is carbon. Yeah, carbon dots. Yeah, dot meaning dot. Yeah, spot containing carbon. So all material at the end will change to carbon. Yeah, so that's why you have to heat. If you heat, overheat it, so getting to black, right? Yeah, whatever you heat will change to black if you use high temperature. So the color of carbon is black. Yeah, so actually you change everything into carbon. Yeah, with heat. So the source of it can be just thermal, can be with a microwave, can be other. Yeah. So at the end, the product is carbon. Yeah, so they don't contain vitamin anymore because all vitamin, all mineral will change to carbon. Yeah, so that's why we call carbon dot. Yeah, so with this carbon dot, first we have to prepare carbon dot. If we want to use this carbon dot as a drug carrier, yeah, so then already carbon dot you have, so you do interaction between carbon dot and the drug. So you don't use microwave method anymore. You don't use hydrothermal because you already have the carbon. So attachment of carbon dots and a drug depend. Yeah, you can just do a normal reaction. Yeah. So you have to consider about the functional group of the drug, which can react with carbon element. Yeah. So this is just chemical. Or you just can attach, not chemically, but I think must be chemically because this is a chemical reaction. Yeah, and then you have carbon dots functionalized with drug on the surface. Yeah, and also you can use, carbon dots and then a drug, in one structure. And then you inject, this structure in the body. Yeah, so drug will function as therapy and carbon dot will function as diagnostic because it will give a signal, as a color or as a whatever, depend on the instrument you use, whether USG, whether CT scan or whatsoever, And how many drug, you have to do a calculation, the dose of anti-cancer, for example, So first you have to do optimization, So if you inject 1 milliliter of carbon dot, so it will go to only one organ, many organ, and how much carbon dots located in this organ, you have to know, and then the second calculation you have to know the molecule content of drug in the carbon dot. After that you will know the dose, and then you will you will know how many milliliter you should inject carbon dot modified with drug to have effectivity, something like that. Yeah, so this is complicated. So you have to do many things step, yeah, many step before you go to the dose. Yeah. Yeah, of course we need a lot of drug, yeah, attached to the carbon dot. So the more drug attached to the carbon dot, the smaller the volume you inject to the patient or to the animal, something like that. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Professor Henny, for very interesting and interactive question and answer. We really appreciate it. So maybe we conclude for our first session of this lesson. Once again, I would like to thank you for your lecture.
Welcome. So may I leave?
Yes.
Thank you. So good luck for everybody, and I hope my short lecture will give you insight, yeah, or short information, and then you will open, you will get more knowledge about this short introduction about the quantum dot and the medical application. Okay, thank you. Stay healthy, stay safe.
Okay, thank you very much.